Hello everyone, I'll be discussing today about Rouché's theorem, which is a topic found in complex analysis in mathematics. And basically what the theorem says is that you have a contour C, which is a simple closed contour, and you suppose that if you have two functions, f of z and g of z, which are analytic inside and on the contour C. So here's the contour that we have here. It's some contour that I've drawn. It can be any. And inside this contour and on it itself, f of z and g of z are analytic. So that just basically means that the two functions are differentiable within this region and on the contour itself. And the next condition, B, right here, says that the modulus of f of z must be greater than the modulus of g of z at each point on C. So if you have these two conditions, A and B, being satisfied, then the conclusion is that f of z and the sum of f of z and g of z have the same number of zeros up to multiplicity inside C. Multiplicity just basically means that you might have some roots of a polynomial which are repeating. So for example, if you have z to the power of 3, you'll have a solution of z equal to 0 with multiplicity 3, because 0 is a root 3 times. So now let's try to take a look at an application for this theorem, and we'll try to apply it. Here we go. Okay, and now the question asks, we want to determine the number of zeros, counting multiplicities, of the polynomial z to the power of 4 minus 2z cubed plus 9z squared plus z minus 1, lying inside the circle with modulus z equal to 2. That just basically means that the circle of radius 2. Now, what you want to do in this kind of problem here is you want to try to find a function for f of z first, which does not have too many terms. You don't want to have too many terms, so that the modulus of f of z will be greater than the modulus of g of z. Now, since we have a circle of radius 2, you want to pick a term that will dominate. The modulus of some term in this polynomial will dominate all the other terms. And I can see here that this term right here will dominate. Because if you plug in for 2 squared, you get 4 times 9 will give you 36. Okay? And if you were to consider all of these terms here to be positive, except for this one, you're going to get 2 to the 4 is 16. The modulus of this, you're going to get 2 cubed, 8 times 2 is 16. So 16 plus 16 is 32, plus 2 is 34, plus 1 is 35. Remember, when I say plus, I'm considering the modulus only. You'll see the reason why we're doing this. So this will only add up to 35. So this tells us that the selection for f of z, our f of z, was correct. It was a good choice for f of z. So now we'll just write it like so. So suppose that f of z is equal to 9z squared. Okay? And now the modulus of f of z is equal to 9 times the modulus of z squared. But that's just equal to 9 times z and then the square goes on outside, which is equal to, or less than, or equal to, 9 times 2 squared, which is just basically 36. Okay? And so we can look at g of z now. So we set g of z equal to the remaining terms in the original polynomial. So let g of z equal to z to the 4 minus 2z cubed plus z minus 1. Okay? And now we can see that the modulus of g of z is equal to the modulus of z to the 4 minus 2z cubed plus z minus 1. But all that is less than or equal to z to the 4 plus 2z and then cubed plus the modulus of z plus 1. Okay, the modulus of minus 1 is just positive 1. And now you're going to see that this is equal to 2 to the 4 plus 2 times 2 to the 3 plus 2 plus 1, which is equal to 35. Now, you have to notice that f of z and g of z are analytic because a polynomial function is an entire function. What it means to be entire is that the function is analytic everywhere on the domain. So that's okay. So condition A has been satisfied in Rouché's theorem. Now, look at this here. The modulus of f of z is indeed greater than the modulus of g of z for every single possible point within the contour. So we get f of z, modulus of f of z, is indeed greater than the modulus of g of z. So condition B and condition A have been satisfied. So we'll put it here. And f of z and g of z are entire functions. We'll just write down R entire. Now, apply Rouché's theorem. Apply Rouché's theorem. And what Rouché's theorem says that the number of roots or number of zeros for f of z will be equal to the number of roots or zeros, same thing, for f of z plus g of z. So that means since f of z has two zeros, then f of z plus g of z also has two zeros. And that's because we're applying Rouché's theorem. That's a result of Rouché's theorem. That's the conclusion. So, but what's f of z plus g of z? But f of z plus g of z is equal to this whole polynomial, which is exactly what we wanted. That's exactly our target. That's what we were looking for. So that means the original polynomial has two zeros. So it has two zeros inside the circle with radius equal to 2. And that's the answer. You have two zeros for that polynomial inside the circle of modulus z equal to 2, or radius of 2. And so that's basically how you do it. If you have any questions, feel free to post in the comments below. And don't forget to subscribe. We'll be posting more videos very soon. This is the Canadian Math Magician signing out. Thanks for watching. Take care.